and fine. We're not exactly strangers. I've already loved you in my mind. You said we're not exactly strangers, you and I. My thoughts are running wild and free while you held me tight. Well, I thought about it and I find we're not exactly strangers. I've already loved you in my mind.
Doing all of them? We'll pick out two of them if you want to do, and I'll just do the last two. It doesn't have to be off this page. Gonna do what a friend we have in Jesus for Mount Wild. And then I'll just call in and I hear that train a coming, it's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when, but I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps a moving all down the San Antonio. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. Well, I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. Well, I bet there's rich folks eating in a fancy dining car, probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. But that train keeps a-moving, and that's what tortures me. If they freed me from this prison and their railroad train was mine, I'd bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
All right, well, we made it again. Made it again. It's another Wednesday night honey hole. Honey hole. Wednesday night honey hole. Man, it's awesome to see all y'all's beautiful faces and people. Even you, David. Hey, we're glad to be here. Glad you're here to join us. Get a good word from Ken here, and rest of us are going to try to sing you a little song. Sing you a few songs if I can talk. Hopefully I can sing. But we're going to get kicked off here with a little I Saw the Light.
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, yeah, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more at night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Take us one thing.
Just like the blind man, I wandered alone. Worries and fears I blame for my own. And like the blind man that God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light. I saw the light. No more in darkness. No more at night. Now I'm so happy. No sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord. I saw. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more at night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Yeah, praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Welcome to Wednesday Night Honey Hole, man. We're so glad you're here. 38. We're getting close, Mickey. We're getting close. Need to step up their recruiting just a little bit. We'll be fine. So we do have some visitors with us tonight, so if you get an opportunity, say hello. Welcome them in. And if you're going to be mean, don't talk to them. So exactly. Would you pray with me? Heavenly Father, we're so grateful for the day. We thank you for the love and blessings that you show us each and every day, Father. We we can't explain the grace and mercy that you show us, Lord, and we're so thankful. Father, we just pray for the opportunity to hear your word tonight. We just ask that our minds and our hearts and our souls will be open to hear the word that you have for us, Lord, and that we would take your word and embed it in our lives, and we would use it in our lives each and every day. We pray for the opportunity to share the love of Jesus Christ with others. And Lord, as we leave this place, Father, we pray that we would act the same as we do in here, and that we, as we walk down the street, people would just know that we're Christians through our actions and through our words and through our thoughts, because we want them to be your thoughts and your words, Lord. So thank you for the opportunity to be here. Thank you for the home that you've provided us to hear your word in. Guide us in everything we do. In Jesus' name, amen.
When the shadows of this life have gone. Fly away like a bird from prison bars have flown. Fly away, oh, fly away, oh glory.
That music. What's going on?
Get to the Lord in numbered with the load of care. Your precious savor still already you take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake
when you stray from the fold and there's trouble in your soul, can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? When your soul is lost in sin and you're at your journey's end, can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? Calling you. Calling you. Can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? He will take you by the hand, lead you to that promised land. Can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? As you journey day by day and temptations come your way, can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? If you follow in this life, He will always guide you right. Can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? Calling you. Calling you. Can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? He will take you by the hand, lead you to that promised land. Can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? When your soul is burnt down and your friends cannot be found, can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? If you'll follow Him each day, He will brighten up your way. Can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? Calling you. Calling you. Can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? He will take you by the hand, lead you to that promised land. Can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you? Can't you hear the blessed Savior calling you?
Cajun. mean, that's hard to go out. That's a little better. Try a little kindness.
If you see your brother standing by the road with a heavy load from the seeds he sowed, and if you see your sister falling by the way, just stop and say, you're going the wrong way. You've got to try a little kindness, yeah, show a little kindness. Just shine your light for everyone to see. And if you try a little kindness, then you'll overlook the blindness of the narrow-minded people on the narrow-minded street. Don't walk around down and out, lend a helping hand instead of doubt. And the kindness that you show every day will help someone along their way. You've got to try a little kindness, yeah, show a little kindness. Just shine your light for everyone to see. And if you try a little kindness, then you'll overlook the blindness of a narrow-minded people on the narrow-minded street. You've got to try a little kindness, yeah, show a little kindness. Just shine your light for everyone to see. And if you try a little kindness, then you'll overlook the blindness of a narrow-minded people on the narrow-minded street.
Best place to be. God is good. Now can you hear me? All right. Well, God is good. Can't say that too many times. All the time. Great place to be. Oh, what all's going on? We got a lot of stuff going on. Yeah, men's breakfast this coming Saturday at 8 o'clock for the guys that aren't out deer hunting, Jimmy. So I'm going to bring up, if y'all hadn't heard, Miss Wanda has moved to Mineola. To Mineola. That's over in East Texas. So I think she's probably too busy to be watching tonight, but just in case she's watching, everybody turn around and say, hello, Miss Wanda. We're going to miss you. Well, Bill did say if you call him early enough, he'd buzz down there and get you on Wednesdays. Yeah, if you ever need way back up here, you got some boys to come get you. I promise you. All right, upcoming men's breakfast this Saturday, 8 o'clock here at church. Intercessory prayer, second and fourth Thursday of the month at Jenny's home, which I ain't going to tell you where she lives. Too many people looking for it. Don't forget our backpack program. coming up the holidays, these kids are going to be out of school, so they'll have less opportunities for meals, so we need to be sure that they have stuff to see them through that. The women's breakfast is 16th at 9 o'clock here at the church. Do they need to bring anything? All right. Bring a friend. Yeah, that's what I was thinking about this. You know, our Wednesday nights are growing. And this is great, so I'll come up with something. Next Wednesday on your way out here, if each of us would stop and pick up a homeless person and bring him with us, they need it. And they're easy to find. If you pull up close to them, roll down your window, they'll come to your car. Anyway, now this is wonderful. Wednesday night's growing. I'm so proud of this. And we're going to hit that 50. And when we do, we're going to celebrate. I don't know exactly what, but we're going to celebrate. I guess, was everyone here for the business meeting Sunday? Anybody not here don't know what's going on? All right. Well, we got our pastor's retiring here in a couple of months, and we voted Mr. David in to take over the reins. So be sure you give everybody your phone number so we can call all these little nuisance problem stuff. But let's give David a hand. And Will. We decided we need his smartness and intelligence and everything back for another term as elder. We appreciate both of you guys for stepping up. My wife went in the closet and come out 45 years younger tonight. So. Anything else as far as upcoming? Won't have it on the fourth Tuesday because of Thanksgiving. Okay. Thursday, yeah. Whatever. Okay. Time for praises and prayers. Anybody got a praise? Yes, Dina. Yeah, she sent out copies of the flyers. Yeah, let's. Yeah. However you do that online, put it on your friends' page or your YouTube or Twitter or whatever that's called. Share it. Get the news out. Yeah, that's great. And we got Toys for Tot going to help us out this year for sure, and that's going to be a blessing as far as what we have to give out. Any other praises? Yes, Ned.
Yeah, Terry Pell, Kim's friend, which I met through Carolyn, but we all met together at the bar. Anyway. Terry Wright, Brandon and Orthis, she came with Carolyn.
All right, great to have you. We got another visitor back there in the corner. Love to have a visitor. Wednesday night's just laid back Wednesday night. Come be yourself, and you don't have to sit over by yourself. These guys don't smell too bad. Kudos. I can point out the worst ones if you need the info. So. Well, one of them just held his hand up back there. He's volunteering. So. All right, Bob. Yes. Let's pray it comes straight down, not sideways, 90 mile an hour. Yeah. Okay. All right. Prayer request. Stephanie, how's your brother? okay. Stephanie's brother's in hospital and still in ICU. Got a pretty rough row ahead of him, so keep Marty, is that his name?
Randy.
Keep Randy in your prayers. Any other prayer requests? Yes. Teresa's son's been having some issues with his house, was undermining the foundation and stuff, and it's bearing on his mind pretty hard, so bring him some peace over that and bring a conclusion to what they need to do to save his house. Jody, do you have something? Pray for Jody's neighbor's family. Their son-in-law passed away. Let's keep all our kids in prayer. Tomorrow night's Halloween. They're going to be out running up down the street, and people's going to be driving and stuff. Just pray that they're all safe and that they don't go to some crazy person's house that gives them something that ain't candy or whatever. This is
prayers for the grandparents that walk with their grandkids.
Yeah. Yeah. And they dress up like them. No. Yes.
Pray for our daughter-in-law, Janice Stalder. She tore her Achilles tendon in her leg, and she goes in November the 16th. And they're cut three bones off of her ankle, and then reattached the chin back to such a
woman. Okay. Pray for Janice Stalder tore Achilles, and she's got surgery with some bone removal and stuff on that. Bill? Pray for one of Bill's co-workers, name's Hunter, had a pretty bad wreck on 35 yesterday and got broken arms, some other injuries. Yes.
Oh.
Definitely. Keep Wanda in your prayers. If you've got her phone number, call her, worry her a little bit and bother her. You know, she's going to need some people to talk to, but biggest prayer is that she finds her little old cowboy church down there, that she can be just just as big a blessing to as she's been to this one. And that'll do her heart good to know that she's needed and appreciated and wanted. So there's got to be one somewhere in the country down there. So any other prayer requests? Unspoken? Go with me in prayer. Lord, we love you. Just as usual, we come to you thankful for yet another day you've allowed us on this earth. Thankful for this house you've provided us in these Wednesdays that you give us to come enjoy the fellowship and love of each other, to listen to the troubadours as they excite us with their songs of praise to you, Lord. Pray for how it touches our heart when the message is brought to us, and that we'll retain this and hopefully go out and share it with our neighbors, Lord. Lord, we've got these health issues and stuff. Just lead, guide, and direct the doctors and the caretakers and caregivers and stuff on these folks, and let's get them healed and back on their feet and back home to where they belong, Lord. Lord, we have other issues in our lives. We've got other issues in this old country going on. Just pray that we humble ourselves, tilt our head back, and look to you for the wisdom we need to get through these things and get back on track, Lord. just as always, watch over our youngins. Keep them safe, happy, and healthy. Keep your light shining bright on them. Keep them on the right path. We just ask these things in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen.
Let me say a quick prayer. Father God, I just come to you this evening and need, Lord, I need you. I need you to walk me through this sermon, Lord. Just be right there with me that I get it right, just like you gave it to me. And Lord, you bless this church. Bless Miss Wanda. Whatever that outcome is. We know you got your hand on that, Lord. I say this in Jesus' name, amen. It's a long night. Anyway, a couple of years ago, Glenn Campbell passed away. And being a John Wayne fan, it brought back to mind the movie True Grit. More than anything, the title of the movie has been rolling around in my head and has led me to this sermon. The title of the movie was named after the character of Rooster Cogburn, played by John Wayne, a man of true grit. And as the story goes, hired hand Tom Chaney, he murders the father of a 14-year-old Matty Ross, who seeks revenge, and he hires U.S. Marshal Rooster Cogburn to track Chaney down, who has retreated into the Indian Territory. In comes Glenn Campbell, a.k.a. LaBeouf, to join the manhunt. It seems that he is also hot on Chaney's trail for the murder of a Texas senator. Here's the deal on Ranger LaBeouf. They should just keep his name Glenn instead of LaBeouf. He wasn't LaBeouf and he's not LaBeouf now. He is Glenn. I had a hard time buying into his character. Anyway, just call him Ranger Glenn. They team up and vengeance is served and they get their man. So the baseline of the story, the root of the message intended, is all about the heart of the man. Here's the first part that I took from that show. Matty lays claim on Rooster because what's in his heart, the character of his heart, not what is seen on the outside, but what is on the inside of him. The grittiness of his tenacity, his fortitude, his perseverance, his steadfastness. But in fact, what she found when she first laid eyes upon him was a pot-bellied, one-eyed, drunken sleuth who has outlived his usefulness, who has been written off by the town folks, and by himself, who wasn't fit for or in any shape to chase down a cold-blooded killer. She wasn't interested in what she saw on the outside, but the grit he had on the inside, his heart, his true grit. It's all about the heart. What God sees on the outside of us doesn't necessarily match up with what he sees on the inside. God is not interested so much on what's going on the outside, but he is interested in what's going on the inside. Your heart, our grit, our perseverance, our steadfastness. our determination to devote our lives here on earth in service to Him by trusting in Him through our gritty faith. Gritty faith, love, and hope. Gritty faith kind of puts a different slant on those three words spoken in the Bible. Faith, love, and hope. They have sort of a softness to them, a kind of a meekness to them. But you know what? There is nothing soft or meek about faith. The grittier your faith, the stronger your faith. It is gritty, strong faith that gets you through the dark times, gets you through the valleys that we all go through in life. I read this article written by Angela Lee Duckworth. She says this: after much research, it turns out that across all ethnic, social, economics, educational, and psychological demographics, one characteristic emerges as a significant predictor of success. It's grit. She defines grit as the ability to persevere in pursuing a future goal over a long period of time and not giving up. It's having stamina. It's sticking with your future day in and day out. Not just for a week, not just for a month, but for years and years, working really hard to make a future a reality. Grit is like living life as a marathon and not a sprint. So a few years back, my buddy, he competed in a triathlon run. He ran, it was a run, swim, and bike. I don't know what order they went in, but I do know that he started training months before. His goal was to finish the race, and he did. It was his grit that gave him that fortitude to withstand the pain and the suffering of training and to compete in that task he had in mind. Everybody was really proud of him after he accomplished that task. So biblical grit is different from worldly bootstrap type grit. With biblical grit, we find our steadfastness and endurance. It comes from the promises of God by His grace. This is how we finish the race. We are led by the Holy Spirit, and we are encouraged by His Word. And there is where our victory lies. Here's the deal. Unlike sin, biblical grit is not a genetic trait. It is acquired by yourself. You do not receive gritty faith from your grandmother or your daddy, or if your daddy was a preacher, or because you haven't missed a Sunday of going to church in 10 years. Biblical gritty faith, true grit, is forged in the fires of adversity. It comes from being in the valley more times than being on the mountaintop, to the point that you do not fear the valleys. They just make the mountaintop that much more sweeter. The word grit is not mentioned in the Bible, not one time. God uses terms like steadfast, endurance, perseverance. This verse here, it speaks of the grittiness of faith. James 1, 2 through 4. Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Let perseverance finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. See, Paul, he knew a little something about gritty faith. He wrote in 1 Corinthians 15:58, "Therefore, my brothers, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourself fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor is in the Lord is not in vain." Steadfastness is the determination to remain at your post, come hell or high water, to stand firm. Endurance is our determination to keep moving forward toward our goals, no matter what the world throws at you. You will be hated by all because of my name, but it is the one who has endured to the end who will be saved. God chose the most unexpected, unqualified, irrational people he could find to build his kingdom. He didn't care about their track record. What he cared about was their heart. He cared about their true grit. Noah, it took Noah 100 years building a ship until God fulfilled his promise. 100 years. Abraham and Sarah, they lived as strangers in the land of promise and waited 50 years for God to fulfill their promise of a son. Joseph, he was sold into slavery and languished in an Egyptian prison waiting on God's promise. Moses, who led a group of on and off again Israelites for 40 years in the desert, waiting on God to fulfill his promise. And then Jesus, the Son of God, sent to die for the forgiveness of mankind's sin. He said, "Not what I will, but what you will." Then moved with relentless determination to the cross. What an example of a true grit man. It's all about the heart. What would keep a Christian from having gritty faith, true biblical grit? The number one thing is fear. Fear of what? Let's be honest. At times, it's the fear of failing. The fear of failing God. The fear of failing our families. The fear of failing each other. Where does that come from? The prince of the world, Satan. He uses fear to bind you, to keep you moving forward to the will of God. He uses everything he can to separate you from God. He wants you to take your eyes off of God and see only the valley, because that's where he lives. Fear produces a cowardly heart. A legend from India tells us about a mouse that was terrified of cats until a magician agreed to transform him into a cat. That resolved his fear until he met a dog. So the magician, he turned him into a dog, and that mouse turned cat turned dog was content until he met a tiger. So once again, the magician changed him into what he feared. But the tiger came complaining that he had met a hunter. The magician, he refused to help him this time. He said, I will make you into a mouse again, for through you, you have the body of a tiger, and you still have the heart of a mouse. Sometimes as believers, especially me, we forget that everything we face in this world is subject to God. Everything that has happened or is going to happen is going to cross God's desk. So if we live our life for God and he's in control of everything, then what is there to fear for us? God gives us the Holy Spirit and his holy word and this church body, you guys, to defeat fear. At times, our adversity may seem bigger or more powerful than we are. But God is all-powerful. And nothing in creation is even close to his power because he created it. It's all about the heart. The first step to developing your own gritty heart is to submit ourselves to God. Truth is, No one can resist the devil's deception and fear tactics apart from submission, being full of the Word of God and under the power of the Holy Spirit. What it is putting on the full armor of God. Life on earth is where the battle is. Life is hard. It's harder than we ever expected. The grittier the faith, the stronger the defense. When I think of having gritty faith, I immediately think of a seasoned veteran, Christian soldiers who have been in the thick of things, who have seen some stuff in their lives, and they don't back down, and they don't back up. They press forward toward the fight. They are the Rooster Cogburns, and we have some in here today. And we have some here that have claimed their final victory. They look down in the valley and they see the enemy and they put the reins in their teeth and a pistol in one hand and a rifle in the other and they charge. They go forward. Y'all remember that scene? Yeah! Pew, pew, pew. Crazy. That's some true grit. There is no failure when submitted to Christ. God will not let you fail when you live your life for Him and through Him. You may die on the battlefield or in the valley, but the final victory was won. 2,000 years ago when Jesus Christ died upon that cross for forgiveness of our sins. Then He rose again in 3 days. Fulfilling His promise to us just as He fulfilled His promises to our forefathers. It's all about the heart. Some people are born with all the physical attributes to be a super sports star, but they have no heart. Dallas Cowboys. Then you can have someone with little natural ability but put their whole heart into the sport and they excel. Thing is, God gives each and every one of us the gift of grace. Doesn't matter who you are, where you come from, we all are given the exact amount of grace. It's up to each person to reject or accept God's gift. To reject it is to forfeit God's blessings here on earth and in heaven and live in fear in the world. To accept it is to live your life in the will of God by your faith and your trusting Him, knowing that there is something far better than life here on earth. Life in heaven. So let's get back to the movie for a second. The next thing that I gleaned from the movie was Maddie, that 14-year-old girl who exemplified the character of true grit. Rooster even said it. She reminds me of me. As young as she was, she set out on a task that required more than she was capable of achieving on her own. Let's look at that statement for a second. She set out on a task that required more than she was capable of achieving on her own. Does that sound like any of us in here? What happens when we take on things that are just too big with us, for us without the armor of God? Most of the time we fail. And when we fail, we come crawling back to God begging for help. So why did we fail? Because we took matters out of God's hands and we put them in our hands. What we are doing is taking away our faith and our trust in Him and bringing on anxieties and bringing on fear and worry and rebellion. Rebellion. When we ignore God, we are rebelling against Him. The lesson comes from Maddie because she had no choice than to call upon someone else for help. She wanted to do the job herself, but knew that she couldn't. But in fact, she did go every step of the way. This is all God's asking us to do, is to call on Him, to trust in Him, to rely on Him, to take our dependence upon Him in the good times and in the bad, every step of the way. It's all about the heart. Gritty faith. I hope you never look at faith in the same way again, because to have faith, true faith, there has to be some true grit. The gift of faith comes gritty faith. You get it through struggling against our adversities. Therefore, adversity produces endurance. And the one who endures to the end will be saved. Let's pray about it. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day that you give us, that we can come into your house and worship you together as a church family. We thank you for adversities that strengthens our faith in you, that builds our character. We thank you for your grace, love, and mercy that promises us with our heavenly home. Please continue to forgive us when we fail you and love us unconditionally. And all God's children say, yeah.
All right. Good one, good one, good one. Man, I love your analogies. That's awesome. True grit. Well, guys, we're going to get y'all out of here with a little Amazing Grace. I hope y'all have an amazing week, and we'll be here Sunday. Y'all come back and see us. Snake, we
Can you learn about old movies? Hey, would you go with me in prayer, please? Lord Jesus, we come to you again this evening thanking you for this day that you've given us, Lord, and for this opportunity you have given us to come together and worship you, Lord, in your house. I pray that as we go our separate ways, that we all have safe journeys home and that we come back Sunday safe and healthy, Lord. I pray for all those on the prayer list. All those names that were mentioned, Lord, that you bring healing and comfort to those people. Ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.